Ahoy, this is Zdenka. Right at the beginning, I'm gonna let you know that I'm actually filming with Canon M50 and also iPhone 11 Pro and brand new Moza vlogging kit, which I'm gonna show you at the end of the video. So pay close attention to the picture quality and also the sound quality. I'm gonna be cutting those views throughout the video. And just to clarify, Moza is not a sponsor of today's video. They just sent me this vlogging kit to check that out. A couple weeks ago, I published a video where I announced that I'm pretty much done with wedding photography industry. And in today's video, I would like to talk about that. The main reason was, of course, the family time, but there are many other reasons why I chose to step out of the wedding industry. Also, another topic I would like to discuss today is Shutterstock. If you contribute to stock photography and video to stock agencies, you will probably know exactly what I'm talking about. A few days ago, Shutterstock changed the payout or pay structure for their contributors, and it has been massive drop. And it's been like a slap in the face. So let's talk about that today. We've got lots to talk about. I've been in the wedding industry for 15 years. When I started as a second shooter. That's usually how most of photographers start. And then I started shooting weddings on my own. I photographed well over 150, maybe 200 weddings myself. This video, what I'm going to talk about, is not to turn you away from shooting weddings at all. This is to prepare you, in case you are getting into wedding industry, what you might be eventually dealing with, what you are getting yourself into. And some of the people will agree, some of the people will not agree, and it's totally fine. Every age category will look at it differently. Every person will look at it differently. Maybe the young generation will not even take some of the things I'm gonna say as an issue because they simply didn't know how it was before. So here are all positives and also negatives. Photography industry to me is one of the fastest changing industries. You have to adjust pretty much on daily basis. When I started shooting weddings, those 15 years ago, I was getting my clients through my website, bridal networks such as Wedding Wire, and also trade shows. I could easily be charging $5,000 a wedding. My clients were from Toronto area, so I'm talking about Canadian market, Toronto area. It might be very different on the country where you live. It all depends on your location. If I was shooting weddings in Oshawa, where I'm from, is about an hour east of Toronto, it's a small town, then I would have to really charge half of the rate just to keep myself busy. Photography rates are dropping drastically. When I started shooting weddings, I was charging $5,000 a wedding, and now I was charging $2,000 a wedding, and I also had to include the second shooter in that price as well to make sure I booked my 23 to 30 weddings a year. I stopped advertising at the trade show because they are super expensive and they don't even limit the number of photographers there. So at the end of the trade show, you are happy if you book your 2 to 3 weddings and you still don't even break even. You don't cover the cost of actually being there. From what I was seeing, number of photographers grew significantly. Well, the digital cameras are more accessible, they are cheaper these days, and it's a great part-time job for many. As a result of that, I had to advertise online more. So I had more expenses, but I had also less income. And then social media took over, and with that, very aggressive social media marketing took over, which I'm gonna be also talking about. The biggest change I noticed last 2 years, and I would say the totally biggest change I noticed last year alone. And it's totally cool that there are so many new photographers and there are so many new videographers. The only problem with that is that they are not experienced enough and they throw themselves in the wedding industry. Instead of working with you, they are very aggressive and it feels like they are there to build their own portfolio, but they are not fully committed of being there to work for a client. In last 2 years, it came to the point that I had to create my own list of preferred videographers. And I had to tell the couple, look, I'm not gonna book your wedding unless you're gonna use somebody from that list. The reason is constantly blocking me from taking the photos, constantly videographers in my way trying to get their shots but not allowing me to get the shots I need for my clients. Also, when you have the time to take some photos of the clients, I was not given that. I had to sometimes fight to get that time so I can actually take some photos of the bridal couple to give it to them. Also, there's a lot of alsos, flying a drone in a very high winds without a license until it was getting dangerous. And I flew drone before, I know what it is all about. Lastly, not knowing the rules, how to behave in church, ignoring the requests from the church, ignoring all those things, it's leading to the point that the priests are not so friendly towards photographers. Do I blame them? No. They have full hands dealing with all those smartphones anyways. Let's talk about social media. As a photographer, I have a contract with a bridal couple where it says that some of the approved images I can post in my own portfolio, but otherwise those are private images, and it makes sense. I would not want to have my own wedding photos circulated all over the internet. Well, lately I have been getting literally bombed from all other wedding vendors such as florists, decor, makeup artists, videographers and all that. If I can send them those wedding photos, and I always politely said, no, I'm sorry, these are private images. The only one who can actually send you the photos is the bridal couple alone. You have to ask them for permission. I simply didn't want to end up in a lawsuit. When I was working, other vendors were taking photos of me as I was working, tagging me on their social media, tagging their business into my business in order to promote themselves. And it would be totally okay if they would ask, but they didn't. I'm a very private person too. Marketing in Toronto has become very aggressive. And to find a very good second shooter who is actually skilled and has an experience, it's quite difficult too. There are many, many, many new photographers, but they are simply not ready to handle something like that. Last draw for me was behavior of wedding guests. And all of it happened last year. And I'm not talking about one wedding. I'm talking actually about quite a few weddings. Mainly the young generation, the very young generation, they are changing. And I would say that the respect is kind of not there anymore. Kicking to my camera as I'm taking a very quick bathroom break is simply not okay. And alcohol should not be an excuse. All of this, besides my eye problem, contributed to my decision to move on. Basically, there is a point in your life when you realize that you don't need to do that. It's not worth having all those anxieties before every single wedding. There are many positive things I will miss. I have met some exceptional couples. I have met some exceptional families I'm gonna miss. I'm gonna miss all those beautiful emotions, taking all those candid photos of those moments. I'm gonna miss all those beautiful locations because you don't get to see them every day. Few of you raised a concern over placing everything in one basket, meaning just being on YouTube. If you've been on this channel for a while, if you watch my previous videos, then you know that I'm one of those people pushing for spider web of different revenue streams. I always had multiple incomes and I always had backup on top of the backup, and that will be happening as well. You're looking at the person who at one point, when I was 19, had no money for food. I was living off bread for a while, and it was the best life lesson I have ever gotten. So besides being on YouTube, you will see me soon spread all over different platforms. Blog, for example, on my website has been already created. That has already started. Spiderweb of different income streams have been created many, many years ago, and I'm gonna be teaching all that in my upcoming courses for photographers and videographers. Bottom line, it is never a good thing to rely only on one source of income, especially if you are somebody in a creative field. So let's talk about stock photography. In particular, let's talk about Shutterstock. I've been contributing to Shutterstock for a long time, for 15 years, and I never been exclusive with them for the main reason that I just don't want to put all my images in one stock agency. I always had many other stock agencies to represent my work. Basically, some of the new agencies came and closed. iStock had some major changes throughout the years as well, and now Shutterstock. A few days ago, they announced that they are changing the earnings structure to their contributors. And what it means, literally, your income is going to be cut in half every single year in January. And it's gonna be also affecting me as well. I'm not going to explain more. I'm gonna link a video which was created by Nicole Glass, a close friend of mine. I'm gonna post it in a video description. You can watch it after this video. She explained it very well. In case you are one of the Shutterstock contributors, she will let you know exactly what is happening. But now let's completely change the mood of today's video and let me show you what I was using throughout this video here. Let me show you this setup. And again, Mozza is not a sponsor of today's video. They sent me this package. In fact, they didn't even want me to do a review, but after using it for a week and after using it actually every single day, it was simply too good not to show it. In fact, I'm actually sending one package to my parents myself. So what is in that box? The box weighs 973 grams. Inside is a tripod made of plastic, extension pole made of aluminium, which can extend quite a bit, up to 720 millimeters, phone holder made of aluminium as well, light made of plastic, which is super cool, and microphone. And it also comes with two apps, which surprised me the most. So very quickly, you can just have it sitting on the tripod, or you can attach the extension pole and you can really attach it far. It goes all the way here. Or you can just have it sit on a table anywhere. And I'm using it pretty much all the time now when I'm calling my family, when I'm cooking, because I like to watch something on the phone, or even when I'm exercising, because I do all those fitness classes. Before, I was using just a tripod with a phone holder, but it's kind of clumsy. You can just put it on a table. This is very compact and a lot of fun. The reason I'm gonna send it to my parents, because when we call each other, they just have their phone, you know, sitting on a table, they use a glass or something to hold it, but sometimes the phone falls down and I see a lot of their ceiling. So now they're gonna have this and I'm not gonna look at their ceiling anymore. And it's just easy, you just slide the phone in. If you want better sound, just attach the microphone. If you have iPhone, you need the little adapter. Otherwise, if you have Android, you just connect it together. And now comes the fun part. The light comes with accessories to soften the light. You can operate it as it is. It is also waterproof. You can use it underwater and it lasts up to 2 hours. It comes with Mirfag light app. The app allows you to adjust strength, color temperature between 3200 and 5600 K. You can use it as flash or even in emergency. It flashes SOS signal. This is an interesting light. Last thing I want to talk about is the other app it came up with, and that app actually really caught my attention. It's called VMaker. It is a simple video editor. But what it also offers is tons of already pre-made templates, which are great. If I had to do that from scratch in Adobe Premiere Pro, I would spend hours. So let's say you're somewhere on a trip and you quickly want to post something on a social media. So you select your template, you select your clips, and a few minutes later, you've got your little movie. This is actually scary how fast those smartphones and apps are advancing. And by the way, you can use this light and the microphone with your preferred gimbal, or you can also use it with mirrorless camera. You don't necessarily have to use it only with this kit. And then if you always don't want to use gimbal, you can just use this. This is a good tool. This is a good piece of kit to have. Absolutely. If I was buying the light and microphone separately, the value is very good. So for those interested to see the pricing, I have linked it below the video in the video description. And yes, those are international links. Hit the thumbs up if you liked today's video and subscribe to future videos like these. If you have any questions, comments, or simply want to say hi or ahoy, you can leave it in a comment section below. And I'll see you, my friends, in the next video. Ciao, ahoy.